This video is about measuring power with the wind turbine setup. We've got a wind turbine already set up here. I've got four blades at a rather shallow angle. We're going off to the wind energy test rig, and I'm just going to go into the light bulb there. So first of all, we'll just have a look and make sure that we are actually getting some energy out of this one. Off and running, it does work, which is reassuring, and the light bulb is lighting up. It's one thing for the students to be able to see that they are getting an energy transformation, but if you're having competitions, you might like to say who's getting the most power out of their wind turbine. There are two ways we can do this. We can start just looking at the raw voltage that they're going to get out of the turbine. We need our STELR voltmeter, and we turn that around to the DC voltage over here. We're just going to connect that straight across the light bulb, and we'll see, put this over here and turn this on. The light's going on and the voltage is stabilizing around about that 2.2 volts. If we want to measure power, we need to measure the current going through the circuit as well. So the voltmeter just went across the light bulb. Now I'll take that out. We'll bring in another multimeter here, and I'm going to turn this one around to the 200 milliamp scale over here. So I'm going to go from the common of this one into the other side of the light bulb, and we're going to go from the turbine into this one here, which is the volts, milliamps and ohm socket. I've got those two running there, and I need to reconnect my voltmeter across those. I turn this on. So our voltmeter is still reading around about that 2.2 volts, and our ammeter is reading around 38 milliamps. And if we multiply 38 milliamps by 2.2 volts, we will get whatever that comes out to in milliwatts. So that gives us a measure of the power. Another thing we can look at here is that if we disconnect the light bulb, we see that the voltage has gone up to around 5.4 volts rather than the 2.2 volts that we had before. So not having a load on the wind turbine will give you much higher voltages. But as soon as it starts to draw a current, the voltage going across the device falls away.